Hello students, today we are going to learn another one topic. Before entering into the topic, please think about these questions. Do plants excrete like animals? What do you think, children? Animals excrete every day, like the same way plants excrete? Yes, some wastes excrete every day, but the solid wastes are not excreted by plants every day. Okay, let us see in later on slides how they excrete periodically and not regularly. Do plants have special excretory organs? There are no special excretory organs in plants, especially like which other animals have. How do plants excrete waste from their bodies? Do you have any idea about this? Yes, plants have some ways to excrete the waste materials. Like you have all seen about stomata, lenticels. I think you got that one. Through the stomata and lenticels, they excrete some type of waste from their body. Let us see what are they. Why some plants excrete gum? And some other excrete milk, sticky like fluid. What is the use of them? Let us see about that. And fourth one, why plants shed their leaves and bark periodically? Do plants shed their leaves regularly daily? No. Yearly once or twice they shed their leaves, and some plants shed their bark also. Like if you take eucalyptus and guava, plants shed their leaves periodically. Sorry, bark periodically, not only leaves, both. Have you ever eaten a chewing gum? From where we are getting that? Do you have any idea? Let us see in this lesson. Have you ever seen varnish? Where do we use it in our daily life? You can get the answers for these questions in this lesson. So let us move on to the lesson. What is our lesson? Excretion in plants. Children, what you are observing in the picture? Dried or dead leaves. The bark which is shedding from the eucalyptus plant. So some plants remove their waste in the form of bark and also in the form of dead leaves. They transfer the waste which is produced inside the plant, that they transfer those waste into this aged leaves. And they in the later on time, those aged leaves fall off from the plant. Like that way, they remove their waste. Okay, children? In this lesson, the learner is going to learn about differentiates between excretion and secretion, and the primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Gives reason for why do plants produce latex, gum, resin and tannin, etc. Identifies the medicinal plants in their surroundings, explains about the secondary metabolites of the plants, appreciates the ways of excretion in plants, applies the knowledge of usage of secondary metabolites in their daily life, identifies the relationship between self-defense and waste produced by the plant. Okay, let us see how these learning outcomes are fulfilled in this lesson, how the children get this knowledge about. First, I want to ask you something. What is the difference between plants and animals with respect to the production of and production and excretion of waste? If we come to plants, there are no special excretory organs. When compared to animals have special excretory organs. So the solid wastes are not breakdown regularly in the plants. That process will be very slower, so the waste, solid waste materials are produced very late, that is slow process. So that is why plants do not excrete waste regularly. When it comes to animals, animals excrete waste every day. Every day, regularly, almost all animals excrete regularly in the form of solid, liquid and gaseous waste. Okay, solid waste like large intestine excretes solid waste, liquid waste excreted by our skin and also kidneys, gaseous waste excreted by lungs in animals. If it comes to plants, solid waste excreted through leaves, bark, flowers, fruits, seeds. What we think that fruits, flowers, seeds are useful, then why we are calling it as waste? What plants do wisely, they transfer the waste materials to the outer covering of the fruit, outer covering or shell of the seed. When the fruit ripen, it fall off from the plant. What happened there? Waste materials are transported to the fruit. When fruit is ripened, that fruit will fall off from the plant. Like that way, plant remove their waste. Plants transfers the waste into leaves. When the leaves gets aged, that leaves fall off. Like that way, plants remove their waste. In the solid form means, solid form, they remove their waste in the form of leaves, bark, fruits, seeds, flowers. These are all the solid waste produced in plants. But they are not remove those waste regularly. It takes some time, lot of time to shed them or remove them from the plant. If we take the liquid, a liquid means the excess water present in the plant, remove from the plant regularly, every day it happens. Liquid waste is removed from the plant every day through how they are escaped from the plant through stomata lenticels. Where stomata is located, children? Stomata is located on the surface, lower surface of the leaf. Upper surface, the surface of the leaf also contains stomata. When compared to upper surface, lower surface of the leaf contains more number of stomata. So through the stomata, plants excrete excess water. Okay, and lenticels present on the surface of stem and also roots. Through them, liquid waste is removed. What about the gaseous waste? What are the gaseous waste produced in plants? All plants perform respiration. What is the waste material, waste gas produced in respiration? Carbon dioxide. In daytime, plants require carbon dioxide. So, carbon dioxide produced in respiration process that is utilized for food making that is used in photosynthesis process. When it comes to night time, that waste carbon dioxide should be not present in plant. So that should be removed from the plant. At the time that carbon dioxide escapes into atmosphere through stomata. And another one, gas produced, waste gas, that is oxygen. Why we are calling oxygen is waste gas? It is breath of life. It is breath of any living organism. Without oxygen, food is not changed into energy. Then why we are calling oxygen is as waste here? That means plant produced food as well as oxygen through photosynthesis process. Oxygen is utilized for respiration in the daytime. Excess oxygen present in plant, that excess oxygen can be escaped into atmosphere through the stomata. So that is why we are calling it here as in photosynthesis process waste. Actually, in photosynthesis process, oxygen is released. That oxygen is used, somewhat used by plant, and some excess one is escaped into atmosphere. Not total oxygen is removed by plants, is not leaving that into atmosphere. Okay, children? Like that way, plants and animals produces different types of waste, solid, liquid and gaseous, and they sense those waste out of their bodies in through various parts. Time, when compared to time, animals produce regularly these three type of waste. When comes to plants, plants excrete liquid and gaseous waste regularly. When comes to solid, they shed or removes the solid waste periodically. It takes some time. Okay, children. So through which parts they excrete, I already told. How do plants manage or send out waste products from its body? I told you stem. Some plants shedding their bark, and they move the waste materials into bark, and they shed their bark. And gases exchange also taken place through stem, because stem has lenticels, holes, a tiny holes present on the stem called lenticels. Through the lenticels, gases exchange, that is waste materials are sent out, producing secondary metabolites. And I will tell you what is secondary metabolites. These secondary metabolites are not completely used by plants. These are waste. Plants, what plants do, the waste materials which they are not useful for them, they convert them into secondary metabolites. Okay, that secondary metabolites are used for plants sometimes for self-defense, to protect themselves from the plant-eating animals like herbivores. Let us see how what they do. Roots has a tiny pores called lenticels. Through lenticels, waste gas is sent out of the plant. Secretion. Waste liquids produced in plant are secreted through roots into the soil. And roots also produce some secondary metabolites. I will tell you what they are, secondary metabolites. And leaves have stomata. So through stomata, transpiration and guttation processes takes place. I will tell you what is the transpiration and guttation. And gases exchange, waste gases also send out of the leaves. Fruits, the waste materials produced in the plants are transported to the fruits covering or outer shell, outer covering of the fruit. That waste cells are called rhaphides, okay, which is present in the fruit. Flowers also produces waste in flowers. Those may be the toxic chemicals or secondary metabolites. And seeds also contains some toxic chemicals. Waste materials produced as some toxic chemicals or secondary metabolites. Okay, children. Okay, now I want to tell you what is transpiration and guttation. I told you through leaves transpiration and guttation process takes place. Now I want to show you how transpiration process takes place. Here my students are doing one activity to show how transpiration process takes place. What they are doing, what they used, just simply they used one polythene cover. And what they are doing, they are tying that polythene cover to a branch. That branch has some leaves. Those some leaves are inside the cover. We have to leave that cover first sometime. After some time, what will happen? Let us see. Some water deposited inside the cover. After few hours, we had observed. See how these water droplets came inside the cover. How these are formed. The leaves, the water which is removed by the leaves are deposited inside the cover. That means what plants are doing, we are not watching them, but every time plants are removing water, excess water in the form of water vapor through their leaves, through their stomata. So we tied this cover, that is why the water is collected into the cover. See the water droplets on the leaves also. These many leaves removed this much of water. If we imagine the big tree, how many water that big tree can remove water in a day. Do you know, children, if a plant takes 100 liters of water, only it uses 5 liters of water for making its food. Rest of the 95 liters of water are removed by the plant, and that water is escaped into atmosphere in the form of water vapor. That is why where many plants located, there rains will be more, because plants transpires, removes excess water, and they forms the cloud. Okay, children? And also another one process I told, excess water present in the plant remove in the form of droplets. See, you are observing the droplets on the leaves. This leaf is the paddy leaf, and this is the variegated leaf from the croton plant. You are observing the droplets deposited on the surface of the leaf. These droplets are came out of the plant. If you observe the plants early in the morning, if you observe the paddy field early in the morning, you will observe the guttation process. You can see this process. You can, okay? This is about transpiration and guttation. Excess water present in the plant remove in the form of water vapor through the stomata is called transpiration. Okay? If it is removes in the form of droplets, it is guttation. I think you all seen how the stomata will be. These are the stomatas present on the leaf. This is the stomata opening in the leaf cells. Okay, children? And I want to show you the lenticels. Where lenticels are located? See, these are the scars which you are observing. Every scar has one tiny hole. That tiny hole is called lenticel. Okay? These are all lenticels. Through these lenticels also, waste liquid, waste gases are released into atmosphere from the plant. Okay, children? Why are weeds and wild plants are not affected by insects and pests? I am leading into another one sub concept. Why plants shed their leaves and bark periodically? What are secondary metabolites and how they are formed? I think you all know in any crop field, in any plant, any field, there must be the weed plants in that crop. So insects and pests do not harm that weed plants, but they harm and create diseases on the crop plants. Why weed plants are not affected by insects means? Do you have any idea, children? Weed plant produces some chemicals, some toxic chemicals, that they store those chemicals in leaves, flowers, etc. Because of that toxic chemicals, insects do not eat them. Insect do not those leaves do not good to eat. That those are not palatable. They are not tasty to eat, and some are deadly. So that is why insects do not bite or eat those leaves and plants. Okay, why plants shed their leaves and bark periodically means they have a solid waste produced in plants very slowly. That solid waste are transported to these bark, leaves, fruit shed, seeds. So they are periodically they are removed from the plants like yearly once, twice, thrice, like that. Okay. What are secondary metabolites and how they are formed? I will tell you. Primary metabolites. What is primary and secondary metabolite? These are the biochemicals produced in plants. Primary metabolites are produced in photosynthesis process. Carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. These carbohydrates, proteins, and fats are useful for the primary growth and development of the plant. These carbohydrates, proteins, fats are useful for plants to develop itself for their growth and development. When comes to secondary metabolites, these secondary metabolites are not useful for growth and development, but these are useful for some other purposes like self-defense. So that is why they are called as secondary metabolites. Okay, children, some secondary metabolites produced by plants are alkaloids, tannins, resins, gum and latex. Primary metabolites contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Carbohydrates, proteins and fats contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. But secondary metabolites contain some other chemicals, some other elements especially. Now let us see what are the uses of these chemicals to the plants and what human do with the with these chemicals. Okay, first I want to show one interesting plant. This is Cinchona officinalis. Have you heard about this? Cinchona officinalis, from this plant's bark, what this plant do? Waste materials produced in this plant, the nitrogenous waste materials, especially that nitrogenous waste materials are stored in the bark of this plant. That that bark, what human did, they find the use of this nitrogenous waste, that is alkaloid. What we call this nitrogenous waste alkaloid, that name is called quinine. The alkaloid which is produced by Cinchona officinalis is called quinine. This quinine is present in the bark. This quinine alkaloid is useful to treat the disease called malaria. Okay, children, what man did, he used this chemical, he used this plant waste for our own benefit. Okay, children, let us see some other alkaloids. Alkaloid is a nitrogenous compound which is produced by the plant. And some other one, and this is tobacco, Nicotiana tobacum plant name. Here the leaves are produced. These leaves contains alkaloid called nicotine. This nicotine is useful to kill the insects. Okay, children. And another one plant, it is very beautiful to see, but it produces cocaine and morphine. Do you know name of this plant? Papaver somniferum. Usually we call this plant in our native language nallamandu mokka. Okay, papaver somniferum. The fruit of this plant contains that alkaloid. Okay, morphine and cocaine. This morphine and cocaine is useful for used as sedative while doing surgeries to patient is not able to get that pain when they in the inject this morphine or cocaine. It is easy for doctors to do the surgery. Okay. And this one is interesting plant, Rowulfia serpentina. Rowulfia serpentina, name itself has it. It is useful to for the people who got snake bite. Here, see two fang bite scars you are observing on the hand. The roots of this Rowulfia serpentina plant contain the alkaloid Riserpin. What we call it? Riserpin. These are the roots of the Rowulfia serpentina plant. These roots contain alkaloid Riserpin. That Riserpin is useful to treat the snake bites. Okay, that is the medicine useful to treat the snake bite. Another one interesting plant, this is the coffee plant, Coffea arabica. This coffee plant produces fruits. These fruits contain these seeds. These seeds, when we crushed these seeds into powder, that powder we can make a coffee. That coffee stimulates our central nervous system. Then we relieve from the stress and strain, and we become very active and do our activities very actively. Okay, that is the alkaloid. Which is the alkaloid present in the coffee seeds, children? Caffeine. Okay, caffeine is the alkaloid which stimulates our central nervous system. And the next one plant is Azadirachta indica. This Azadirachta indica, you all know, neem plant. Neem plant contains the alkaloid nimbin. Where this nimbin alkaloid located in neem plants, all parts of this plant has nimbin, like flower, leaves, fruits, all parts contain this nimbin. The taste of nimbin is it tasty? No. So a herbivore plant do not eat it. So how they are protecting themselves, like this way, the toxic chemicals or waste chemicals they are storing in leaves, flowers and fruits. They are some bitter taste, so other animals do not eat these plants. Like this way, they show self defense. Okay, and another one plant, that is Datura stramonium. And this plant contains the alkaloid called scopolamine. Okay, and another one plant, chrysanthemum. In chrysanthemum species, there are so many varieties of chrysanthemum plants. This is chrysanthemum, and this is Tridax procumbens. We commonly called it as Gaddi Chamanti. Okay, this chrysanthemum species has the alkaloid called pyrethroids. This pyrethroids is useful to kill the insects. If we keep the smoke of these leaves inside the rooms, this smoke will eradicate the mosquitoes, okay, from the rooms. Okay, like that way we can use these leaves or flowers also contains the pyrethroids. Let us sum up the alkaloids present in the plants. Alkaloids are nitrogenous compounds produced in various parts of the plant. We have seen up to yet fruits, roots, flowers, leaves also has some alkaloids. Okay, quinine is produced by Cinchona officinalis plant. From where it is produced? Bark. It is anti-malarial drug. Nicotine from Nicotiana tobacum plant. Leaves are useful as insecticides. Morphine and cocaine are produced by Papaver somniferum. It is fruit is useful. It is used as painkiller. While surgeries we use this. Reserpine, Rauliflora serpentina plant. Reserpine is produced from the root. It is useful to treat the snake bites and also useful for high BP patients. Caffeine is produced by Caffea arabica plant, and caffeine is produced in seeds. It is a stimulant of central nervous system. Nimbin is the alkaloid produced by Azadirachta indica. Nimbin is present in seeds, bark and leaves of the plant. It is antiseptic. Scopolamine is the drug produced by Datura stramonium plant. Flower and fruit contains scopolamine. It is a sedative. Sedative means like a painkiller, like, okay, what we call in our native language, like Mattumandu, right? Pyrethroids is chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum plants produces pyrethroids. Flowers of chrysanthemum contains pyrethroids. It is a type of insecticide. Okay, children, these are all the alkaloids produced by the plants. Now I am moving on to another one waste material produced in the plant, that is tannin. Tannin mainly produced by the plants acacia, and this is cassia. Acacia arabica and cassia plants produces the tannin. Generally, tannin is in brownish color. This is the tannin produced by these plants. And this processed tannin is this tannin powder. This processed tannin powder is used to polish the leathers. Okay. Tannin is generally produced by acacia and cassia plants. Okay, these tannins are the carbon compounds. Another one waste material produced or secondary metabolite produced by the plant is resin. Resins are produced mainly from pine trees. This is the pine cone. Okay, what is the use of this resin? Resin has it is also sticky one, and this is used in the varnishes to paint the wooden furnitures or wooden doors. Okay, and another one secondary metabolite is gum. Why do plants produce gum? When they got any injuries, plants generally produces gum. To heal that wounds, plants produces gum. Okay, and this gum is also useful for us. We are using this gum in making medicines, in food industry, and also in binding industry. Okay, generally neem plant, acacia plant, there are so many plants produces gum. Actually, they produce gum to treat their wounds, but we are using it for other purposes. Okay, children. And another one interesting secondary metabolite produced by plants is latex. Latex is a white, milky substance, sticky substance produced by some plants like a rubber plant and also sapota. You all know chiku fruit, sapota, and also papaya plant. Some plants produces this latex, and this one is the rubber plant. This rubber plant produces latex. That latex is useful to make the rubber. Another one interesting one I want to show you, children, that is chewing gum. How chewing gum is made? Chewing gum is made from the plant chicle plant. See how chewing gum is made. I want to show you with this video. Okay. These are all the Manikaura chicle cell, chicle plants. From this chicle plants, they are going to collect the latex. Now let us observe the latex produced by the chicle plant. See, this one is the white, milky, sticky latex. And this latex is used to make the chewing gums. Manikara chicle plant. That one is Manikara chicle plant. See this one, they make the scars on this bark like this. Then the sap is produced. For every 14 years, a plant can produce the sap or latex like that. They are collecting the latex from the chicle plant. See how they collect the latex. They are making the grooves on the plant like that. And fixing the bag, collecting bag to the plant. Have you ever eaten a chewing gum, children? Is going up and making more grooves on the plant to collect more and more latex. Let us see what they do. This is the latex collected from the chicle plant. They are boiling that latex. See, now it is ready. This is how chewing gum is made. Now it is ready to chew. Okay, children. Chewing gum is a type of latex which is produced from the Manikara chicle plants. Okay. And another one, a secondary metabolite produced from the Jatropha plant, that is Jatropha plant gives biodiesel. This biodiesel is produced from the seeds of the Jatropha plant. Okay, children, these are the secondary metabolites produced by the plants, like alkaloids, tannins, resins, latex we have seen up to yet. And do roots secrete? Yes, roots also secrete some waste materials and useful materials. And waste materials are removed from the plant and they send it into the ground. Do you think there is any relationship between reduction in yielding and root secretions? Yes. If we observe the crop, any fruit orchard fields continuously for years, the production will be reduced because of the waste secretions into the soil. Why do we get peculiar smell when we shift the potted plants? Means because of that waste materials produced into the soil. Okay, because of that only. Why I am saying is it is experimentally proved by the scientist Brugman. Okay, Brugman studied on the apple plants for years, and he told that the crop production will be reduced because of the waste produced by the roots which are secreted into the soil. Okay, children, let us see what is the difference between excretion and secretion. Excretion is the removal of materials from the living being, completely removing from the living being. Secretion means, while secretion is the movement of material from one point to other point, it is not completely removed out of the body. Okay, humans excrete waste materials such as tears, urine, carbon dioxide and sweat. They are completely comes out of our body. Enzymes, hormones and saliva are the secretions in human. They are not comes out of our body, but they secreted in one place and transported to other place. For example, hormones, if we take the hormone, one hormone which is produced in the head, that hormone is transported into to the kidneys. The saliva produced below the tongue, that saliva is transported into the buccal cavity. Okay, produced somewhere and it is transported to other place. And that is moving from one place to other, not completely removal of out of the body. And another one, in plants too, we find excretion through roots into its surroundings and fall of leaves and bark. Okay, plants are removing waste through falling through roots and also falling of leaves, bark, fruits, flowers, etc. Secretions occur in the plant body in the form of latex, resins, gums, etc. Okay, this is the difference between excretion and secretion. Let us see the summary of what we have seen up to date. Excretory organs in plants like stomata, lenticels, some other, and secondary metabolites like alkaloids, tannins, resins, gum, latex, excretion and secretion. Okay, children, answer these questions and send the answers to your teacher. Write the differences between primary and secondary metabolites. Where do we use gum in our daily life? What are the plants present in your surroundings which contains alkaloids? What are the ways of removing waste from plants? How excess water can be removed from the plant? Write differences between excretion and secretion. Give examples for which secrete tannins, which plants secrete tannins. How do plants show defense against herbivores? Okay, children, I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye.